Dun, 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 dun. Hey guys, Tazzy Faye here. What's up? It's been a minute. I know. Oh my god. I like never met a videoist. It's a real problem, but that's all right. You know what? I'm still living, I'm still breathing, and I'm still getting my paychecks.
Money, 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 money.
Not from YouTube. So I got a new pair of frames and, you know, I really like the style and whatever.
Psych! I don't need glasses no more.
Alhamdulillah. Now the right way to celebrate is to say thanks to God. Not that way that I did. That was very bad. For those of you guys who follow me on Instagram, you already knew. You already knew it wasn't a surprise. Now, if you like surprises, just continue to not follow me on Instagram.
Cause I want it that way. Tell me why.
I'm really excited to share this with you guys because I understand. I understand for those of you who have really bad eyesight and are like,
oh, what am I gonna do? Am I have to wear glasses?
You know, this was an amazing discovery for me. I didn't know that I was a candidate for this surgery. So basically, probably since I was like 7 or 8 years old, I've been wearing glasses. I am now 27. So my latest prescription before the surgery was probably at a -9 in both eyes. That's just like an estimate. Like if I took off my glasses, I could not tell who you are even if you were standing right in front of me. Now there's three types of surgery. You have regular LASIK. Now, if you don't have like really bad vision, it's also about the thickness of your cornea. You're probably a candidate for that, which is the simplest surgery. The second option that people have and that I had was PRK, which is LASIK, which is an older version of LASIK. They don't cut a flap and do the laser. They actually remove a layer of the epithelial tissue and they do the laser after they dissolve that.
I forgot to mention the third option, which is ICL. It's a lot more expensive and it's a lot more invasive.
So as you can probably tell, I'm very happy, alhamdulillah, with everything, you know, that I went forward with. So I'm gonna go ahead and go into the actual surgery and the recovery process so that you guys can know a little bit about that. I did my surgery on a Thursday afternoon at about 2 p.m. So I was like pacing around. I was so nervous before I went in.
Okay, so we're like 3 hours before the surgery and I'm trying to prep. I'm just cleaning up everything. I am more nervous about the recovery than I am the actual procedure, because the procedure is pretty quick and everyone says you don't feel anything and I can take anxiety medicine if I need to.
So when I've been reading online, people say that they're really sensitive to light and my room gets pretty bright even with the blinds closed. So I don't think that this is enough. I'm gonna have to put another blanket over it probably. And then I'm gonna have to cover this one as well. So what happened was I go in and then they take me into this back area where there's like recliner chairs. And then, you know, I had a hair cap on and whatever. And then a lot of places offer you a pill for anxiety in case you need it. I did take it. I don't really feel like it had an effect on me. Maybe that was the magic of it working, but I don't really feel like it did anything. So then they put numbing drops in. A lady came out. She started talking to me about what I can expect for the procedure. Okay, she really freaked me out because she came and she was like explaining the surgery. And I was like, I'm not getting LASIK, I'm getting PRK. And she's like, oh, I'm so sorry. And then I started freaking out after that. I was like, dude, does the doctor know? Does the doctor know? Is he gonna accidentally perform the wrong surgery on me? But really it was just her stupidity. So that's like probably my only complaint. Yeah, I was not happy about that. I was freaking out a little bit and I was like, yo, like I can still feel my eye. Like, I don't think it's working. And she's like, no, we're gonna numb you 2 more times. And I was like, and then that made me a little bit more comfortable. So after, you know, the medicine kicks in and the numbing kicks in, they actually had me go into another room. They assessed my eyes one more time and to make sure everything was correct and looking the same. And he numbed me again in there. And then it was surgery time just a little bit after that. So I went into the room. My heart was beating so fast as I got onto that chair. And my mom was able to stand outside and watch it. And so she actually recorded a lot of it so you guys get to see. You lay down and you're kind of looking up and you're so anxious about what's about to happen. I did a lot of research. I'm the type of personality that I have to know what's gonna happen, otherwise I'm gonna freak out. I'm a control freak. So for me, as he was doing the surgery, I like knew, I was like, okay, now he's doing this, now he's doing this. So it kind of calmed me a little bit in that sense. I didn't really feel any pain. It felt kind of weird. So he first put like a little ring around my eye, put stuff to dissolve the layer of tissue. And that's when things started to get kind of like foggy. Like it was kind of like,
he took my vision away from me. Like, things started to get a little blurry. I mean, my vision was terrible in the first place, but it made it definitely like hazy or foggy or whatever. You know, he would kind of clean things up, and so I could feel like, you know, all that stuff going on, but it wasn't painful. And then the laser started, and all I remember is like kind of like, not a light show, but I saw like red, I don't know how to explain it, like dots almost. And I didn't feel pain. Some people say they could smell it. I don't even remember smelling anything, honestly. But they had the laser on my eye for a long time because I guess the worse your vision, the longer the laser goes. So after that, he put some cold stuff on my eye. And I think that was the most uncomfortable part, but it really didn't last very long. So it wasn't that bad, but that was, I think the worst of it was the cold stuff that he was squirting on my eye. And then he put some medicine in and whatever, put a contact bandage lens on. So by the time he moved to the second eye, I honestly like did not even notice. I didn't feel anything. I had no more anxiety. It was nothing like that. But yeah, basically they finished up the second eye. I couldn't believe it was so fast, even though I knew it was gonna take such a short amount of time. I got up and I could see, but I couldn't see. Like, I could definitely see, and I could see probably a little better than I could see when, you know, before the surgery. However, it's still like foggy and hazy, but I still felt emotional. I didn't cry or anything, but I felt like this like happiness that like, whoa, like, you know, I'm done with this. I wasn't in any pain when I left. However, things started to definitely get watery, and like I had a hard time keeping my eyes open. But yeah, I don't remember exactly all my recovery, but I will label the videos, you know, whatever day it was so that you guys can know.
Had my surgery. And it's weird because I can see now.
Can we just take a minute to appreciate how I look like Steve, who served in the Marines and just finished two tours in Iraq? America!
I can see, but everything is still really blurry. But I can see still way better than I did before. But I'm actually really tired and my eyes are feeling uncomfortable. So I'm probably going to eat and sleep when I get home.
Okay, so it's been a few hours since my surgery. Right when I came back, my eyes were super watery. It was hard to keep them open. Yeah, I just have these on for when I sleep. I was trying to nap. I was listening to an audiobook, but I have trouble focusing in real life, so it's been kind of a challenge. That's how my eyes feel right now. Can't focus on anything. Jeez. So I'm currently reading this or listening to it. I don't know if that was in focus. I don't know. Everything seems to feel kind of muddy. Like, I can't really see stuff, but I can see way better than I did before, if that makes any sense. Like, is this in focus? Okay, bye-bye.
Alright, so it is day two. I'm going for my post-op, my first one. That's about 9 a.m. Last night was fine. I do feel like I have like a contact that's really dried out in my eye, but I haven't felt too much pain aside from when I first came home. My eyes were watering like crazy, but I'll let you guys know after the pre-op appointment what happens. All right, whatever.
Okay, so it's been 24 hours, maybe like 28 hours now. It's 8:30 on Friday. I'm not really seeing any better. It's still blurry. I've been using these drops like crazy. They gave me a pack at the clinic. They're like artificial tears. I had to buy a lot more because I went through those really fast. And that's helping me with the dryness. I am starting to feel a little bit of pain. It's more like aching. I would say on a scale from 1 to 10, it's about like a 4. So it's not, is this in focus? I can't even see, my eyesight is bad, so I don't know if it's in focus. But yeah, I have my occasional moments where I start watering like crazy. But I think watching so many videos and reading blogs and stuff, I prepared myself, and I think it's not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. However, you know, we still got a ways to go, so I'll keep you updated.
I don't know if you can see the band-aid on my eye. I can't see it when I look in the mirror, but there's like contact bandage lenses currently on them, and they should be coming off on Friday, or what? Tuesday, inshallah. And I'm trying to remember not to rub my eyes. So when I sleep, I have to wear these.
So today is Saturday, and I will say last night my pain significantly increased. It was at like a 3 or 4 or maybe less, and jumped up to like a 6 or a 7. It was just like, it felt like my eyes were just scratched everywhere, and I kept tearing uncontrollably. So I got up a few times through the night, but I'm seeing a fluctuation in my vision. So like at times it's like super clear and I'm like, wow, I've never seen like this before in the last 20 years. And then sometimes it just gets really hazy and foggy, kind of like a dirty contact. But I've been putting in eye drops a lot. I don't know, I'm excited because I feel like I see the potential there of what I'm gonna see. But I'm not gonna lie, this day rough, like, you know, it comes and it goes, but sometimes like it gets so watery and so scratchy. I cannot open my eyes no matter how hard I try. So I'm kind of feeling a little bit gross because I haven't really showered or done anything. They told me I could shower, I can't have water going into my eyes, but I'm thinking I'll just wait until maybe tomorrow.
All right, guys, so it is Saturday night right now, and I am in a lot of pain. It's probably the worst that I've had. I have a banging headache from like the strain, and all the eye drops and medicine drops are going back into my nasal cavity, so they're giving me some sinus issues. I have noticed one thing, that when I'm sitting upright and standing, it's a lot better than when I'm laying down for some reason. I think this is going to be the worst of the worst from everything that I've read. You know, at some point during recovery, it's going to get bad, but then it gets better. So I'm anticipating that in the next 12 or 24 hours, the pain is going to go away, but my eyesight will get worse. When I get eyelashes in my eyes, oh my god, that hurts so bad. Yeah, I'll keep you guys updated on what's going on. I would say keep me in your prayers, but by this time I will be through this, inshallah. So, yeah.
Okay, so it is Sunday morning, and I'm feeling much better, as you can see. I finally took a shower. I feel really good. But last night was the worst of the worst. I think that was, you know, what everyone was talking about when they say recovery hits you at some point or another. I woke up several times, but alhamdulillah, I was kind of anticipating that today I would feel much better, and I do. My vision is okay. You know, it's not, like I said, it's like way better than it was before I got the surgery. However, you know, it's not perfect. I can get around and stuff, but sorry, this is, I'm a little sensitive. But yeah, I feel better overall. I think my eyes, like when I can see them, they're still, so my eyes are pretty swollen still. If you can tell, they look all like puffed up, but we still got a ways to go as far as recovery goes. I still have about 2 days before I get the contact bandage removed. You know when you have a contact in the whole day and you just want to just like rip it out, your eye is strained to an extreme, but I didn't have the option of taking it out.
What's up? It is day 4, if I'm saying this correctly, because I think when people talk about the surgery, people count day 1 as the day after the surgery. So technically it is day 4 for me. I'm feeling good. My eyesight was really clear this morning. I feel like it's kind of going like this today, but it's way better than yesterday. Yeah, my vision was pretty bad yesterday. I noticed that my left eye is recovering slower than my right eye. So my right eye is kind of a little bit ahead of my left eye, which when I Googled it, I guess it's normal. Tomorrow I get my bandages off. So yeah, I feel like a new person. I'm really excited, but I feel like it's kind of like odd for someone who wears glasses, who's worn glasses for so long. It's kind of hard to like understand, like, whoa, like I'm not wearing glasses. Or even the concept of like, oh, my vision's blurry, I can't just pick up something and put it on, is kind of hard for me to understand right now. Yeah, but I'll keep updating you guys. Like, yeah, bye.
Really bad. So I took Thursday off, I took Friday off. I worked from home Wednesday and then went back into work Thursday. If I'm being completely honest, I feel like you should have like 10 days or 2 weeks off, and everybody's different. I went back to work, but it was still difficult for me to see. Like, it was a lot of this, you know, and it was a lot of like, I blew up everything to make it big. Like, people say, oh, you can go back to work in 4 days. I don't recommend that at all. I think you should take a minimum of a week. And if you're able to take 2 weeks, I think that's good. But I didn't even take a week. Yeah, a month after the surgery, my vision was much, much better. However, there was still like a little bit of room for improvement. It's strange because it was like when my eyes would water up or if I would cry, I would see like crystal clear. But it gave me hope because I'd be like, oh, like, so maybe I'm not at my perfect vision yet. Yeah, so now it's been like 2 months since my surgery.
I actually recorded this a while ago. It's July now, so it's actually been like 5 months now. So
This is kind of old, but I thought this video was already long enough, so. And at this point, alhamdulillah, my vision is really good. I am seeing 20/20 now, so.
I have moments where I go like this, thinking I have glasses, or like in my mind, I'm like, man, I gotta take my contacts off when I get home. It's very strange. You'll find yourself having moments where you're like, what? I can see without glasses? It's really weird. But I understand it takes time for the cells to rearrange themselves. And so it's just a longer healing process than the other two surgeries. So if you're impatient, I would say this is not the surgery for you. And yeah, I'm like really happy about this. And I hope that this video can, you know, help someone else out there who is looking into the surgery. So I noticed I don't really have migraines anymore. You know, I don't have pain here. You know, I still have breathing problems, but it's not as bad. It's definitely significantly better. One thing I will say that I'm experiencing that is a little frustrating is I have times where I'm like really, really dry. Like I will wake up in the night and my right eye will be so dry that it is excruciatingly painful. Like it feels like there's sand in my eye. So I also live in a very dry place. I would encourage you to go and like at least just go do the free consultations and see what they say, because that was it for me. I had no intention of going in and getting surgery, but it just happened. Like I went to one consultation and then I was like, you know what? I need to do a bunch of other consultations. And after that, my heart was just in it. And I was like, I have to get surgery now. Yeah, that's my story. I hope it helps some of you guys. If you guys have any questions, let me know. And yeah, take care now, you heard. Okay, that's my whole story. All right, Tezzy Faye out. Bye.
I want it.